And the things that we are going through in life is not in line. Sometimes we look at the situation and it becomes so huge. We see it as very big. And then we make us limited God. But this God is a God that fulfills his promises. Whatever he has told you, he will do it. All you need to do is to make a step of faith. Remember the book that I've written, stepping into your greatness. There's greatness in everybody. As I've said it many times, that any child born on this world come with their hands closed like this, meaning that they came with something. So you are not a useless person. You are somebody unique, somebody extraordinary, somebody that you have been born to bring a change to this world. Some years ago, when I was in Israel, and the Lord spoke to me about this vision, building Jeremiah and a school ministry and the retreat center in Israel. I was in Igini, one of the places David High to preach, to pray. I looked at the project and I looked at me. It is something that's going to cost over $2 million. I said, God, can I afford it? I can't. Now, already I put my charge over $4 million debt. We are praying, we are paying. I cannot even go and tell them. You know, at that particular time, I was thinking like a human being, but I'm not thinking that the magnitude of God's power that you can do all exceedingly above if we can trust him. And many Christians come to church, they are born again Christian, but they have not had encounter with this God. We believe in him. The Lord said, go ahead and do it. And you remember the story 2 years ago when the pastor's appreciation day, the money that he gave it to me, I was about to use that money to buy a car. $17,000. The Lord said, this money is a foundation money for this project in Ghana. I said, God, this money is just a peanut, small. He said, no. Anytime I want to do something, I need a little thing to stand upon me. I took that money together 2 years ago. Called Bishop James Sam, one of the great bishop friends. He kneeled on the ground and prayed the ground. And he prophesied that this man, this project will never lack money. From that day up today, over $700,000 I put into this project. And I don't know how the money comes from. Because God is able to do anything that he promised. If it is from God, he will take care of you. So in your academics, you are friends who are at the age of 50. I can't go to school. If God put in your spirit, take a step. Is there any business you want to start? Don't look at what it will cost. Look at him. He's too big to fail you, to disappoint you. One day, God promised Abraham that Abraham, I will send your children into captivity for 400 years. He said, after 400 years, I'll bring them back from Egypt to their promised land. After 400 years, the Lord let Moses be born. And the day Moses was born, the Bible said, the king of Pharaoh of Egypt made a declaration that every male child born into the Jewish family shall be killed. But God preserved this young man. He was raised in a Pharaoh's house, as we know the story. But when Moses tried to do it with his own strength, he ended up being a refuge in the Midianite. The Bible said one day, when he was tending the sheep of his father-in-law Jethro, the Spirit of the Lord came in the form of a fire and said, Moses, I'm sending you to Egypt and go and deliver my people. Moses said, God, how can it be? I'm a stammerer. I don't know how to talk. You see, Moses put himself that it is God, it is him that is going to do the job. But that he know that this God of Israel, the Elohim, the Almighty,